Greetings to all. Welcome to the Art and Science of Teaching, Level 3. Today's lesson will be focusing on Topic 1, Unit 3, on components of OBE curriculum or Outcomes-Based Education Curriculum. After this lesson, you should be able to define and explain outcomes as a component. And lastly, you should be able to analyze the contextual factors that affect teaching and learning. OBE curriculum is divided into five components, namely the outcomes, context, learning content, strategy, and lastly the assessments. However, in this lesson, we're only going to focus on only two of them, which are the outcomes and the context. So here's what I'll do. I'll briefly define each component and then discuss each one in more detail later on. I'll start with the outcomes. Outcomes can be defined as the learning results. This is what learners can do with what they know after the lesson. The context can be defined as the circumstances, conditions, or background of the learners. Learning content can be defined as the content or what the learners have to learn in the classroom. Strategy can be defined as the plan or the action designed by you as a teacher to help learners achieve the desired outcomes set by the Department of Education. And lastly, assessment can be defined as a series of tasks set in order to obtain information about the learner's competence. The task set in order to determine the learner's progress or competence. Now let's look at the outcomes as a component in more detail. William Speed, the father of OBE, defined outcomes using four distinctions. Firstly, he referred to the outcomes as the demonstration of learning. This is things that learners can do as a result of learning. For instance, if you teach your learners about health-related issues, they should be able to apply those hygienic behaviors in real-life situations. And secondly, William Speed argued that outcomes should describe significant learning, not trivial learning. In other words, learning should have value and significant impact to learners in their future. Once they have completed their studies, learners should be able to solve their everyday problems using the knowledge they gained at school. And thirdly, the important idea in Speedy's or William Speedy's definition need to demonstrate is that learners need to demonstrate their achievement in an appropriate setting. The environment should stimulate or copy the real life setting so that learners will be able to demonstrate their understanding. And lastly, he argued that learners should demonstrate high quality learning. Now let's move on to the main types of outcomes. We have three types of outcomes, namely the traditional outcomes, transitional outcomes, and the transformational outcomes. I'll start with the traditional outcomes. Traditional outcomes, it is when students demonstrate a specific subject content met at school or in the classroom setting. This can be done by reading a passage out loud or reciting a poem to demonstrate the English or Tshivenda language skills. Learners could also be asked to create a poster to demonstrate their understanding about the content. For example, on topic about the shapes and colors. You could ask your learners to make a collage of different shapes using different shades of colors. Now let's move on to the transitional outcomes. This is when learners combine the knowledge that they have acquired from different subjects to solve a particular problem, both at school and outside school. Remember, with the traditional outcomes, you demonstrate the understanding of a specific subject. Now, with the transitional, this is when the learner combines the knowledge they've acquired from different subjects, not only one, but different subjects, to solve a particular problem, both at school and outside the school. Learners can also use the understanding of one subject and apply it in another subject. For example, you could ask your learner to conduct a research on HIV and AIDS or water crisis affecting his or her a village or area. So in this case, a learner can combine or integrate knowledge from different subjects such as life orientation, mathematics, languages, and technology to conduct a research about that issue on HIV and AIDS and water crisis. Lastly, the transformational outcomes. This is when the learners combine the knowledge they have acquired from different subjects together with their pre-existing knowledge or prior knowledge to solve their current everyday problems. This is where learners have to apply their past learning, prior knowledge, the prior knowledge or past knowledge that they have gained from school or outside school. It can be at home, in the community, to solve problems in a current situation. For example, you could give your learners a baseline practical assessment at the beginning of the year to determine what your learners have learned in the previous grades. Now, let's move on to the context as a component. Context, like I've indicated earlier on, refers to the conditions, circumstances, geographical location, and the background of the learners. Remember, context and outcomes, the component that we just talked about, context and outcomes are closely linked. Remember, all learners nationally, from Limpopo to Cape Town, have to achieve the same learning results, right? However, the teaching methods and learning materials used may be different because of the context or the area that the school is located. The materials or the teaching methods used may be different because of the context or the geographical location of the school. Learners in the villages of Limpopo, for instance, have poor access to learning materials compared to the learners in the urban areas. And as a result, teachers will be forced to use examples to explain subject matter content depending on where the school is located. So, under this component, we have two